Mike Windsor and Lady A, Lord Dylan there dropping out of contention. Ready the Waves leads them in inside the last half mile from away the load of the Texan. And then up the inside is Duke of Rockingham just looking for some racing room. Imperial Hurley holding him in. Rip Windsor and Tedwin Hills are both in touch. Wide open. The last three furlongs. Away the lad and Duke of Rockingham by the side of the Texan. With Tedwin Hills coming into it on the outside. Brave the Waves beginning to fade. Rip Windsor is next. The front six have drawn well clear. Entering the last quarter of a mile. Duke of Rockingham with the advantage now. Stretching on by a couple of lengths from Tedwin Hills. Red Windsor moving into third as away the lad fades. The Texan has weakened. Duke of Rockingham with the race in safekeeping. Well inside the final furlong, having drawn 7 lengths clear of Red Windsor, who's gone off in pursuit in front of Tedwin Hills. And away the lads, Duke of Rockingham for Aidan Coleman and Ollie Murphy has won by 7 or 8 lengths. Second place has gone to Red Windsor ahead of away the lad, Tedwin Hills, the Texan, and Brave the Waves.
Yeah, 183 and pretty straightforward for Duke of Rockingham, despite being slightly hampered on the home turn there. Let's go down. We always make the way down the far side of the track and take the longest. Oregon.
Debbie Johnson of Ranches in second. As in the great, the need Debbie Johnson of Conrad is third. Followed by Son Dredge, this one's inside, the Teofilo. And last of all, it's Rodzia, from the family of white terms of viewers making debut here at Fast Company. So the turn to back straight. The five runners are headed by Oregon. 3 and 4 left right back to the second one in the mediator. Third, Son Dredge on the inside. Last run. Finishing 5th in the Group 1, Manchester Town Bopper, behind Kill Cross, from the Bopper at Nam. Next up on the outside is Castle McGree, and last remains Rodia. So racing along the back now, we should be heading on towards the mile column, but out front is Oregon and Leeds. The racing next here is 2nd, Subjects right behind them 3rd, Castle McGree just outside, and last of all Rodia. So midway along the back straight now, out front. The advantage to the mediator is racing high round the course as the main is so drenched Castle McGree and Rodia to bring the way to back in front is Oregon by 2 or 3 lengths to the second row of the mediator. Back in third Sun Dredged and then Castle McGree on the outside and Rodia last of the group. In the turn now, along the back straight is the Lisburn and Castle Ray City Council flat race. And towards the inside, Oregon and next is the flag drop. The project to the inside, Sun Dredged to the inside of Castle McGree and behind them is Rodia. So now we begin to emerge on the way out of the back straight. Racing to do as Oregon leads by a widening margin to the mediator in 2nd, Castle McGree on the outside of Sun Dredge and Rodia last of all. Continuing now on the rise towards the top bend and it's Oregon. Some Scirocco chasing along, followed by the mediator, Castle McGree on the outside of the Fast the 5. Sun Dredge just behind and Rodia right behind again. They begin the run towards the top bend now, the short descent with Oregon continuing to show the way. The mediator Castle McGree, Sun Dredge just behind. And Sun Dredge just asked for effort there, and the gap to the leader is reducing. It's Oregon from the mediator is almost on terms now. Sun Dredge just trying to pick up, and is doing just that now in the centre. So Sun Dredge to the inside of the mediator. Oregon under pressure. Castle McGree is ridden. Rodia is trying to get into it. The five will come with a couple of lengths as they come down the hill. Sun Dredge to the mediator is between them. Right behind them is Rodia. They're being chased by Castle McGree as Oregon drops out. They head down towards the elbow. And the mediator coming up on the outside of Sun Dredge just ridden. Rodia is trying to come through the centre. That gap's closing. And it's the mediator now who holds the advantage. Sun Dredge just come under real pressure. Rodia has gone into 2nd. They're clear from Castle McGree. But now the mediator is beginning to draw clear from Rodia in 2nd. Sun Dredge can give them more than Castle McGree and Oregon. But stretching up inside the closing stages, it's the mediator who's drawing clear. And don't mind this convincing. It's another opening day winner for Gordon Elliott. Jamie Butterworth this time. The mediator winnings down back in 2nd is Rodia.
Yeah, the Kopmeister aboard the mediator for another winner for Gordon Elliott, and Rodia was a distant 2nd. So average as well, that wasn't the greatest of bumpers, it has to be said. 6 over 3, 1 for 3 favourite at Down Royal. Well, we've got our first race at Dundalk coming your way of the evening. Of course, we've got double evening horse racing action at Dundalk on the old weather in Ireland. And of course, here at Canton Park, this evening's card starts at 5 o'clock. Opening race at Dundalk, 9-4 Orinoco River. Jarvis 5-2. 7-2 from 9-2 Sacred Territory. 9-2 Octane and 13-2 Bar the Four. That's the scene at Dundalk as they go to post.
Tracked in by Orinoco River and down the line. We have two long
455, Knickerbocker Glory, 13-8, 7-4, Streamer Stars, Guardino, 9-2, 7-1, Monte Igualdo, 18-4. And once again, that boost of one more. Trap 2, a 5-2 shot. One more, we're about to go behind the trips.
Well held, but it's waiting to go close on his best ball, the vice for down. Sir Cedric. All looking for a double on the card. Catra is one last time. Trinity Island. Reigns at maiden. Just his second start for the stable. And pretty well first time at Catra as well, considering. It's one Jaminka for James Fanshawe. Daniel Musker, fourth ever start. First handicap. She's been third in all three starts so far. Two on the all weather, one on Pontifex on the turf. Also Thunder Lolly, number nine. Seamus Jorah, Tom Queely, winner of Chepstow on Firm Ground in August 6th, and in 2-12 runner events since. One there for Pantre d'Etoile on 16th bar. Hellmark's coming out here, the favourite. So, price is no longer available. Hellmark has been withdrawn. The favourite is a late scratching here, so there'll be a real four significant message. The big news here is the late on, they're taken out to the favourite Hellmark. A bit of a delay. 5-3-4-1 more, 8-1, 7-2, 4-53-28, track at 2-3-7-42, Longs and Fian ultimately getting on top there. Weather video going down, 6-4 down in front of Glory, 9-4 Stream of Stars, or Billy Godino, 10th bar. So Hellmark withdrawn here, so if you haven't placed an early bet, it's going to be quite a significant rule for with a favourite out. So the prices are no longer available. When there will be time for a new market, it's debatable. There is, because we've got one here. Last Identity of Goddess of Fire, now 9-2 joint favourites in the new market. Super 11-2, so Cedric still 15-2 as he was originally. It's Thunder Lolly 10th bar. Let's say that those who took an early price are subject to rule 4. If we're not running late in the day here, others seem to be causing a few issues as well. It's Identity now the 4-1 clear favourite. So Cedric, you're looking at several degree in the rear of shot. Weather, as you can see, going down officially, although it certainly looks like the majority have arrived at the start. First at Kempston's around the corner as well. 5 o'clock priced up Aurelia Gold. 6-4 there for that first. If you're going to want to go forward, that's the Identity of one of them. See who is joint favourite once again with Goddess of Fire. They're 4-1 each of two. Newton Jack going in. He's been assigned to stall 14. It looks like we are finally just about ready. Let's go get the call here, Bartlett.
The raceway over a mile coming out. Jeff Inga, Marco de Twelve, Espresso, Fredo, the Love Trio to get into the stride. Goddess of Fire is the first one to show bonuses with this and just goes past and now. Also, Newton Jack is in company with those as they all come right over the grandstand side running well. Jaminga, like Jack in darkest, he's about 3 from left. He's starting to get away with Van Abner now. Lockham is on the extreme left. Last Identity and also Thunder Lily behind the leaders as they settle down. And then comes Cedric is towards the back of the field. With this as well is Super Dance from the big blue visor he's got on. And Espresso Fredo, remaining red jacket and white cap, is just at the rear. They get the halfway. With on the point bonus, a darker jacket, the red sleeves of Goddess of Fire, they race together. Super Dem travelling up strongly behind them, in red and yellow, Newton Jack, Jaminka, Fidel behind these, and then one from the left is Marco d'Etoile. A step on the break comes under it on the extreme left now, between that pair is the Cedric trying to come through with the runners, they head down to the two furlong marker. Newton Jack is on the extreme right, the green and red colours of Goddess of Fire. Masked Identity, white and blue jacket for Josephine Gordon has come through to take it up now. Espresso Fredo coming from the back of the field. So Cedric is still there with a chance as well. Masked Identity to Espresso Fredo is getting a real shift on the far side. Goddess of Fire nearest to us. Newton Jack is still there. Masked Identity is going to win now. Just held on there. Second position, Espresso Fredo and Goddess of Fire behind those Newton Jack.
So a terrific battle of Masked Identity on the Josephine Gordon. Nice to click on down with Espresso Fredo, Goddess of Fire just in behind. On the inside was third, 2-8-6 there at Newmarket. They haven't held for us here of Weatherby, they're about to go. No 11-8, Nickerbocker Glory, 9-4 Prima Styles, 7-2 Cadino, Harbour Lake, Gamble. 9 Jamaicans, 12 bar. This is their final race. It's your last chance to place a bet. Up to Hazard and not runner. Kepta going down the rail of gold, 6-4 favour there, still left. Not quite ready at either club. If it goes great, but both may well or probably will go off during this Wetherby race. We're up towards the tape with around another 50 yards and a few seconds more to go. Let's go and join Richard Hoyles.
Often racing for the next 365, obviously, sir. Shenanigans at the start to stop attraction. Yeah. Once the tapes were released, and has a narrowed lead early on. Racing in second place is Stream of Stars, green colours with the pink cap towards the far side, Wardino as well, as they head on towards the first. First Angel race is in fourth place, being tracked by Scorching with the red cap. The Sue Smith Brigade made up of the pink cap of Seven Arches, who's the best placed of the trio as they step over the first. Over towards the back of the field was Hilton Lee, company past the Malachy, as they head on towards the second. Top attraction in the nose belt, and Guardino, they both rise over it, and we lose there. Dunover has come down at fight number two. He is swiftly on his feet, okay, but was gallops away fine as well. So on towards the third. All over that one safely. So top attraction, the shifting out to the right of the hurdles has the lead from Guardino and the DFO brothers towards the inside.
Yeah, shit today. See you later.